Before using Lightroom AI Denoise again, make sure you understand exactly what it's doing to your photographs, because it can create potential problems with your edits. In this video, I'll explain everything you need to know and what to avoid. I'll share the reasons why I use it at a very particular stage in the editing process, and I'll also share some vital tips along the way. Lightroom AI Denoise does an amazing job at removing noise from photographs. It's extremely simple to use, but it's also very easy to run into problems if not used in the correct way. But before we talk about AI denoise, it's important to understand what Lightroom is actually doing to our photographs. Once we import a RAW file into Lightroom, we have our RAW file with a Lightroom edit sitting above it. When we first begin editing a photo, we start out with a blank edit. When we start adding in different effects and slowly build up an edit, the appearance of the RAW file changes. At no stage does the Lightroom edit change the actual RAW file data. It only changes the virtual appearance of the RAW file in Lightroom. All effects in the develop panel work in this way, except for the AI denoise feature. When we run our photograph through AI denoise, Lightroom removes the noise and spits out a new RAW DNG file for us to work on. When using AI denoise, Lightroom inspects the RAW file only. It completely ignores all the edits applied. To use AI denoise, go to the details panel and click the small denoise button. In the enhanced preview window, you will see the edits you have given to your image, but AI denoise completely ignores all of that, looking at the RAW file data only. Once AI denoise has finished running, a new DNG file is created, and then Lightroom copies over the edits from the initial RAW file and applies it to the new DNG file. To demonstrate this clearly, I have this RAW file with a virtual copy. The left photo has no edits applied, with the right photo receiving some severe edits. I'll run these both through AI denoise, both with an amount of 50%, and I'll show you the results. The image on the left is the new DNG file with no edits applied, as per the initial RAW file. And the one on the right is the new DNG file with its respective edits carried over. Yes, they look different, but what if I reset the edits on the right? They become 100% identical. I'll zoom in to 200% to show you that Lightroom has applied AI denoise in an identical way to both photos. This confirms that Lightroom AI denoise completely ignores any edits applied in Lightroom and only looks at the RAW file data. So why is this important to know? When Lightroom carries over an edit from the initial RAW file to the new denoised DNG file, it applies the edit in a similar way you would apply a preset. This is fine if you've done a basic edit with basic sliders, but a potential problem arises if you've used AI masks, complex masks with range selections, or clean up parts of the image with a healing tool. To recreate the edits on the DNG file, Lightroom has to make new calculations, and it's possible that it won't be identical to the initial RAW file. This can lead to some major flaws on a finely tuned edit if the new calculations are not identical. I can never take that risk. When is the best time to run AI denoise? For other reasons, which I'll mention shortly, I recommend running AI denoise before you do any masking or any cleanup work. But ideally, if the image needs noise reduction, I would highly recommend you run AI denoise before you do anything. In a previous video I made on the AI denoise feature in Lightroom, I mentioned running denoise late in the workflow, but this is not advisable anymore. Apart from the benefit of not messing up any masks or healing work, there are other benefits to running AI denoise in the beginning of your workflow. The biggest benefit is having Lightroom create AI masks in a more accurate way, especially when critical details are involved, like fur on a lion, for example. Lightroom seems to make better AI mask calculations on cleaner files. It's also easier to judge the effects of the clarity and texture sliders on a clean image. Sometimes those textures can be hidden amongst the noise. Color noise is also removed very well using AI denoise, and this helps bring back subtle colors in your photographs that were potentially removed when using the color noise reduction slider. If you've applied AI denoise to an image and the result looks a bit too smooth, go into the effects panel and add a very slight amount of grain. This repairs the image and makes it look a lot more natural. Learning how to use Lightroom correctly can do incredible things for your photography. So click on the screen here and check out this video next for 7 tips to help improve your Lightroom editing skills.